Muchas gracias. As a, I'm going to speak in English. As a landscape architect, all my presentations had a lot, always have a lot of pictures and landscapes, but today it's an institutional presentation. So I will try to summarize the International Federation of Landscape Architects ideas. And for that, I thank you very much, the organizers, to have this opportunity. We heard this morning and yesterday some definitions of landscape architecture. Another one, the profession that applies aesthetic and scientific principles to the design, planning, analysis, and management of both natural and built environments. Landscape architecture has his roots deeply embedded in nature and culture, and embraces an interdisciplinary field that comprises several major components: humanities, social and cultural sciences, technology, and the creative arts. Thus, the role of the landscape architect is fundamental to an integrated and holistic planning process, which develops landscape strategies alongside social, economic, and environmental policies. In 1948, the International Federation of Landscape Architects, IFLA, was founded in Cambridge. Today, represents 76 member professional associations from Africa, the Americas, Europe, and Asia Pacific. IFLA was admitted by UNESCO as a non-governmental organization in 1970. The European Foundation for Landscape Architecture was established in 1989 and became the European region of the IFLA. Now we call it IFLA Europe. Today, IFLA Europe represents 34 members. What is the role? IFLA Europe, with an holistic vision, establish, support, and promote the landscape architectural profession across Europe, contributing to international discourse, shaping and disseminating European initiatives, facilitating the exchange of information, whilst promoting excellence in professional practice, education, and research, culminating in a cultural, rich, diverse, and sustainable Europe, trying to contribute. The objectives of this federation was not only deal with the professional itself, but encompass a wider focus on of the interests which deal with landscape and people, economics and environment, aiming to at achieving a solidarity-based society which understands landscape as its core matrix. It is in this belief we understand several organizations have much in common with us, following similar goals and objectives. This is, was our past president, a Spanish, Ana Luengo, in 2015. That's why, along last decades, IFLA Europe established a cooperation network. With ECLAS, the European Council of Landscape Architecture Schools, that exists to foster and develop scholarship in landscape architecture throughout Europe, by strengthening contacts and dialogue between members of Europe's landscape academic community. ECLAS starting the process at Berlin in 1989, and formal and corporate identity only in 2006. Le Nôtre, an international thematic network project, stands for Interdisciplinary Education on Landscape. The goal is to enlarge horizons and engaging with the neighboring disciplines. In 2000, was created in 2001. ELASA, the European Landscape Architecture Student Association, which promotes the support, cooperation, exchange of ideas and understanding between landscape architecture students throughout Europe. It was created in 1990. Uniscape, IFLA Europe became observer member of Uniscape in 2017, considering in particular a collaboration on issues regarding landscape policy making and education. One picture from Le Nôtre meeting at Sarajevo in 2014, just to stress that we have students, teachers, local experts working together in a project. That's the annual meeting of Le Nôtre. Of course, we based in some fundamental documents, the agreement to form European Foundation for Landscape Architecture with the aims and objectives of landscape architecture education, reciprocal recognition of academic qualifications in 1989. IFLA UNESCO Charter for Landscape Architecture Education in 2005, the European Higher Education Area Framework of Qualifications for the European Education in 2005. More documents, European Landscape Convention, of course, from the Council of Europe in 2000, explained with some other recommendations from the European Landscape Convention, and also a guidance document for the recognition or accreditation professional education in landscape architecture, the International Federation at the World Council in 2008, and ECLAS, the schools, Tuning Landscape Architecture Education in Europe in 2010. And finally, Las Palmas Declaration of the University Rectors for Landscape Higher Education in Europe, 2018, the Charter of the European Landscape Architects, a core document which defines tasks and competencies towards the profession and other associations and society in general in 2018, and an important report for about professional recognition of landscape architects by one of our colleagues for the Council of Europe this year, very early this year. IFLA Europe was included as an observer to the Council of Europe with the commitment to close collaboration in pursuit of the aims and objectives of the European Landscape Convention, which states that each party undertakes to promote training for specialists in landscape, appraisal and operations, and recognizes the need for trained professionals, experts in the broad field of landscape architecture. The Convention also states the need for the establishment and support of schools and university courses, which in the relevant subject areas address the value attaching to landscapes and the issues raised by their protection, management, and planning. Since landscape architecture is an art and science, landscape architectural education should be regarded as the manifestation of the ability to conceptualize, coordinate, and execute the idea of environmental design rooted in human tradition and the knowledge of natural system. Keeping this in mind, the development of a mainstream professional training system for landscape architects has always been one of the principal objectives of IFLA Europe and IFLA World, and the maintenance of the quality of professional training and professional stands forms a central part of the activities of IFLA Europe. That's why IFLA Europe maintains a permanent schools recognition panel. Lists with the details of landscape schools can be found in the website, and this panel includes always two members of ECLAS, the Students Association. Landscape architectural education is available at universities, polytechnics, institutes, and academies. The education leading to formal qualifications and permitting professionals to practice in the field of landscape architecture is to be at university level, with landscape architecture as the main subject. At present, in 22 states, there are about 95 professional training colleges and universities offering over 200 courses. Most of these programs are recognized by IFLA Europe, and this is very important to ensure professionals' free circulation. For some years, it's a detail what I'm going to say. For some years, some schools strongly provide design-oriented professional training. But from the beginning, for instance, as mentioned today, the first course in Portugal, in Lisbon, by Professor Caldeira Cabral, since the beginning, considered an holistic approach combined with appropriate management, considering that this is the core of landscape architecture, and promote as well landscape strategic planning at local, regional, and national level. Today we have two objectives to the European Federation. The objective is a high degree of harmonization, both in professional training and practice, developing and practicing core levels of expertise and skills, but another objective, nevertheless, considering as well the need for a diversity of professionals who can respond not simply to national differences, but also to rapid change that is affecting society at all levels. Of course, today we speak a lot about the changing of landscape. Of course, the profession is still continuing to adapt, responding not simply to society's changing needs and aspirations, but also to constant change affected by global matters. Landscape have been created through an organic and cumulative process, including both geological episodes and activities lasting many millions of years, but also through human influence for millennia and by innumerable generations of people. You said this, that before, landscape changes, always change along the years, and we think it's not dramatic. It changes, it's alive, it's dynamic, so it changes. At a time when the environment is known to be under considerable pressure, we need to face the contemporary and the emerging, both the contemporary and emerging challenges, keeping in mind some principles. That's why we tell the students, keeping in mind some principles, ensuring transdisciplinarity, and considering landscape as multifunctional, cross-cultural, and at multiple scales. Landscape architects are trained to deal with this change and look to some concepts, which is funny. Now it seems to be very modern. Some concepts like natural capital, stock of natural assets, blue-green infrastructures, ecosystem services, and so on. But these principles have been, and these concepts have been considered long time ago under other designations, such as we used very much continuum natural, that involves most of these concepts. But we recognize, landscape architects are trained to deal with this, but we recognize the complexity of the landscape allows many disciplines to converge in favor of its care. Specialists in geography, civil engineers, agronomists, architects, lawyers, and so on. All the list I put there. This is an image from the north of Portugal near Galicia. Just to show the complexity of the landscape, human settlements, agriculture, forestry, and so on. Because of this complexity, that's why we think it is important to be together at these seminars and share some ideas about landscape and education. And that's why I am very pleased to be here and to have spent these days with you. Thank you very much.